Hello and welcome to Art Workshop with Paul from the northeastern highlands of Scotland. It's the 24th of June 2014 and this is the second video on this subject, and I'm sorry that I'm going to have to read all of this, but there may be possible legal ramifications, so I don't want to forget anything and I don't want to leave anything out. So first of all, let me thank all of our friends, both those who know us personally and all of those out there on the internet, for the love and support they have shown us over the last few days. Since our last video, many of you have worked tirelessly, trying to right the injustice done to us, specifically by YouTube and Google. I know that you have made efforts to contact the media, both local and national, in your own countries. You have also struggled to contact local YouTube and Google offices and those further afield. Some have even suggested starting a petition on the website of the British government. Without your support, the present cloud over our lives would have been unbearable. So what has happened since our last video? In its final few frames, we made a point that we had been served a copyright infringement notice, which had been the first strike, and that it only needed two more and our channel would be permanently terminated by YouTube. On Monday, the 23rd of June, the second and third strikes came in quick succession. So fast, I believe that the criminals hoped that we would not spot them. However, Ireland was on the channel responding to supporters and saw the second. This time, the culprit went by the name of George Brutus. I'm convinced that this is an alias, so apologies to other George Brutuses out there, but it is as well to know that someone is using your name. Once again, we were frozen out of our YouTube channel. Eileen was preparing to file the YouTube counterclaim form when the third strike hit our channel from yet another bogus identity. Now, I'm sorry about the pronunciation here, but it's Tule Taztan, or T-A-S-T-A-N. As is YouTube's policy, our channel was shut down permanently without us having any right of reply on both strike 2 and 3. In my mind, it appears that YouTube, by the manner in which they have set up their operating systems, are enabling copyright theft while disabling genuine copyright holders from claiming their rights. Our channel now has this banner to welcome new visitors, which I cannot help but feel is a slur on my professional standing. Eileen and I have always been ardent upholders of copyright legislation, making sure that we protect the copyright of others as well as our own wherever we can. We have many friends in the art and music world who would attest to this. We have been asked by other video creators whether they too are vulnerable from such bogus copyright claims. Could someone, by simply using three false names on the internet, close their channel because they felt they had a grudge against them? We had to admit that although this is totally illegal, YouTube would not raise a finger to help them. Because of its intractable systems run by machines, the closure of their channels would be inevitable, just like ours. Can YouTube not conceive that such cyber attacks could become commonplace, leading inevitably to a massive increase which would leave innocent creators everywhere sitting targets? So beware, all independent filmmakers. Load your videos onto YouTube and they are no longer your own. Open channels. Become partners. It will not save you from the criminals who exploit YouTube's failings. A final thought. In my mind, it seems that YouTube have stolen over 260 of my videos, for I have no way of reaching them, and they still hold them on their servers. They also are in possession of Eileen's annotations, which make the channel so totally interactive, along with all the comments visitors to our channel took so much time and trouble posting to all our videos. Even were they to delete the channel content, all that effort would be lost forever. We were partners with YouTube, but partners are supposed to support one another. Our relationship with them can never return to what it was, for we have lost all confidence in their fidelity, and their attitude of, "We're all right, Jack, look after yourself in court," leaves a lot to be desired. Thank you again for all your time. Thank you for all the love you have shown. We pass it back to you all.